Right, welcome once again to the Tennis and Technology Museum, and as we can see, we've been having the Sony U-Matic deck on the bench, and we've been able to repair the audio fault. Yes, the audio fault was a record fault, which was to do with the biasing on the record, so we've been able to find that fault and fix it, which was actually just here. So now it will record. We've recorded a few tracks, as you can see. The unit is prepared and ready. It works quite well. We've recorded a few items on it. This is what the U-Matic tape looks like. They're actually built as two different sizes. This is actually the smaller of the two. This is 20 minutes, this tape. But of course, the reason why it's so small and why it's so large, for that matter, takes so long, is because of the high tape speed and the high bandwidth associated with it. So let's push it in. It starts to lace up just there. And as we can see, the tape will load around the whole drum like that in a big U form, which is why it's called U-Matic. Okay, so let's press play. And as you can see, we got video and audio. Actually not too bad for a machine that hasn't had any mechanical work done on it. This is a relatively professional machine which came out in the late 80s. It has a very effective search function, so you can go forward and backwards. Let's just have a look at what that looks like on the screen, shall we? We go forward. There she is. So there we go.